Well, here it is, guys. First battle in the T10. God, I feel sick. I feel physically ill. There we go. You will notice I did take some of the ammo out of the turret. And yeah, right away, first thing I noticed about driving this thing, look how quickly it accelerates. I mean, we're like full speed with T-54s in a heavy tank. I mean, at least they made this thing a heavy and not a medium so it doesn't get artillery, but jeez. Oh, and apparently as it gets upgrades, it'll get even faster. Which isn't surprising. I mean, that's the same thing with every tank. But I mean, for as fast as this thing took off and got accelerating right there at the very start for an absolutely stock tank, pretty crazy. Let's see what we can do here. On both sides. There's a capture in the first battle. Not bad. I did remember to change my research over to parts, so that's good. Rocket guy right there. We can actually see him. Yep. No? Just took a hit on my driver from something. That's not good. Yeah, very not good. Lost the gunner. Oh, okay, we can get away. That was close. Turret, amazingly, is still good. How about that? I lost two crew members there, a driver and a gunner, but my turret's still good. And the breach. Alright, we're gonna back off, because that M60, I think it is, has got a pretty good drop on me there at that point. Dude, turn around. They're taking the point right next to you. Okay, I was clicking on the fire button. I don't know why I didn't fire. I was absolutely pressing fire there. I mean, I'm not surprised whatsoever that he killed me there with... And then he killed the guy right behind me. I mean, come on, dude. Alright, slightly disappointing start. I really... don't know how I didn't get a shot off on that M60 in the first battle, but on to battle two. Bring that big old 14.5 around, boys. We never know when we might need to completely destroy some vehicle AAA with a 14.5 machine gun and, you know, not have to waste our actual ammo. Or completely destroy an aircraft, because this thing has got the best anti-air belt of any airplane in the game. Wow. Whole team. Whole team. Oh my god. Oh wow. Whole team is T-10s. What are we fighting? America and Germany. So if we don't encounter a mouse head-on, that'll be a problem until I get heat FS. Well, it's not really. I mean, I shoot it in the cheek turret. Turret cheek, rather. It'll be fine. Probably shouldn't get too far ahead of my teammates, but I mean, geez, when you can do 24 miles an hour with a stock tank down the road, you might as well, you know? How did that not kill him? How did that not kill him? I mean, no question about how that killed me. No argument there, but... How many times have I been hit right in that spot where I hit him in my M60 and it's killed me? Alright, here we go. Battle number three. Battle number two wasn't quite as bad as battle number one, even though I got killed faster. It was a little more... I got the shot off and it didn't work, so I don't know. Maybe it was more disappointing just because I got the shot off and didn't get the result that I was pretty sure I should have gotten, as opposed to the first one where I had a shot into the side of the guy and missed it, or just didn't... Well, I mean, I didn't miss. It just didn't get the shot off, but... Let's see. See if we can get around this dumb spawn point they gave me around this castle and get over to the capture point here. One thing I forgot to check in the first two matches is the ability of this gun stabilizer on this tank, and the ability for the gun to not bounce. I mean, you can already see it right now. Look how much this gun is moving up and down. I mean, that's hilarious. If I was driving anything else, it would be up to the sky and back down again. I mean, look at that. Look at how much that went up and down. That is insane how stable that gun is. You can fire on the move with this thing and be reliable. Look at it. I'm not doing anything to the mouse. I mean, besides just steering it to keep it on target. I mean, the direction I'm pointing, but I'm not moving it up and down at all. All right, once I get straightened out here, I won't touch the mouse at all once we come around, right? Okay, so we're gonna drive across this terrain and I've got my hands off the keyboard and the mouse. Just cruise control only. Look at the bumps we're hitting. Not too bad right now, but there's some. Look at how quickly that gun came right back down to center. I didn't do anything there. I'm back on the controls now. But I didn't do anything at all in that little period there, and that's just crazy. All right, I get an AI kill here. It's not going to count. Doesn't count for my first kill yet, because it was just AI. But I'll take the research at any rate. I do, after all, still have to get parts for this, because as everybody knows... Oh, hello! Yeah. Well, that sucks. Oh, and there's a Leo there, too. This is less than preferable. Okay, he dropped down, the Leo's coming up on me. Crap. Turn turret. Oh, thank you. I guess. Where'd you go, JPZ?
Oh.
Where did he go? There's a mouse coming, looks like. I think the JPZ turned around and booked. I think he turned around and booked it. Likely waiting in ambush. There he is, right there. Shoot. There we go. First kill. First kill on the T10. Uh-oh. Oh boy. Yeah, well... I'd like to see where he killed me there, because I have a lot of trouble. HE! Really? Where? HE right into the... Really? Alright. That's a note for the next time I'm driving my mouse. Huh. Okay. So be it. I need to say that when I'm playing against the Soviets, not playing as them. Here we go. Battle number four in Stalin's Chariot. Let's see if we've got everybody else on the team in T10s again. No, not quite. Close, but not quite. A few names I recognize, on the other team especially. Let's see what we got here. Oh look, we've got a friend. Slow down, I'm going as fast as I can! It's an M103 up there. This thing would turn. I could get a shot on it, but I don't think that's probably not the best idea, but I'm going to try it anyway. Let's hope he doesn't have a massive reload. Oh, ricochet off of him. Again, in a place where I've been killed more than once from a head-on shot from a T10's default round. But, alright. I mean, I can't be too mad if an M103 is surviving a hit from a T10, after all. It's a bit personally disappointing just because of how many times I got killed, but if they've made strides towards balancing it, look at how quickly that stabilized. Look at how quickly that gun came up to stable. My goodness, I'd have been waiting still for a shot in an M103 myself, which is probably how I killed him, because he was also coming to a stop. Oh god, angle. Hey! That's a familiar name. Sorry, buddy. Fair's fair. I don't know how he didn't kill me. Honestly, he should have. He got the first shot off in a good place. Along my side. It might have just been in barely enough of an angle to bounce upwards off of there, but Heat FS shouldn't do that. I mean, I'm not. Oh shit! I thought that was an M60. It looked like an M60 facing away from me. I was starting to say something there and I don't remember what it was. I got distracted by the M19. I think it was just, or M42, whatever it was. I think it was just, I'm not complete. I don't want to, whatever. Uh-oh. What? Okay. What the hell round did you kill me with? Wow. Fair enough, I guess. Alright, so halfway through, this will be battle number 5. This time, as it is a conquest map, and hopefully the point should be right here, since judging by our spawns. It could be over here, but I think it's going to be the center. Either way, I'm going to try... Yep, it's the center. Okay, so I'm going to try rushing the point with the T10 using the mobility that the T10 has, and the armor and firepower that the T10 has, and see if I can't hold out at the A point and capture it. Getting slowed down a little bit by the sand here. See if I can get a little jump out. See if this hard pack road makes any difference. Doesn't look like... A little bit, not too much. See if we can crest this hill fast enough. Maybe we can beat the Leos there. That's what I'm gonna run into. That's gonna be probably what's gonna kill me, either at the point if I make it there or before I make it to the point. Probably gonna be a Leo with heat. But, so be it. That's the way it goes. Oh, no! Well, that pretty much just did us in for getting to A. Alright, so the T10 doesn't fit through that little gap there. I'm still gonna press for A, but I think I probably just lost the ability to make it there fast. It's a good lesson for the next time, and for any of you guys who have a T10 or are working towards yours. When you get it on this map, if you try to run up the center there, you're not going to make it through that little gap there like you can with most other tanks. See, there we go. Took a hit there. I see where it came from. Yep, I see ya. See if we can get a shot back on him. Yep. I knew he was going to be reloaded in time. Eh, just like I called it. Leo with heat got me. Right before I got there. Alright, well, last match, having been about what I expected, I'm going to try a little more conservatively this time and go south up the ridge there, see if I can't get some shots down on people. As this is a battle map and not a conquest map, I can afford to take my time a little and not have to try to rush the conquest point to try and put pressure on the enemy to move into it and expose them to fire from our team. Which, by the way, pro tip, you win conquest maps by capping, not by camping. I'll just throw that out there. Anybody who's ever actually played with me or against me will probably have seen that. Well, not against me, because I usually don't type that in all chat, but certainly on the same team, on a conquest map, where we are losing because the team is camping and the other team takes the point and all the tickets bleed away. That usually gets me pretty frustrated and angry going on when that happens, when the team just straight up ignores the capture point. Like on battle, you can afford to ignore the points for a while and do some thinning out their numbers. Do some battle, do some camping and sniping. That's appropriate in this type of match. But in a conquest match, you gotta try to get that point as soon as possible, or at least keep them off of it. I mean, at least get to the point and defend it if you're not going to cap it. Keep them from taking it to keep them from starting the ticket bleed, and then you're forced into action before too long. This guy's got at least 700 kills in that, with the SB and RB multiplier notwithstanding, but... Well, I guess that's not entirely true. He could have bought it. Could always buy the camo. I sometimes don't really take that into account because I'm not about to do it. Oh, there's Leo right there. If you just bring the gun down. Shit. Okay, we're alright. He's still probably going to reload before I am, but... He's definitely got better ammo. He's got the new camo. Where are you, dude behind me? What are you doing? Look at how immediately ready that gun is. I don't know if this is the right angle, but we're gonna try it. Yeah. Wrong spot. Yeah, now he's looking. Alright, well. Hopefully that tree is gonna cover my right flank here. Let's see if we can get another shot up there at him. There's the Leo again. That was unfortunate. Cactus, what are you doing back there, man? Where'd you go? Oh, you went up there. Attention to the designated grid square. I think that's AI shooting at me right there. Leo's still there. Leo is still there, and he just fired. Beautiful. Did he get killed? He did not get killed. We'll take care of that. We'll just take care of that. Alright, I'm pretty sure that's AI shooting at me. I'm going to wait till I get reloaded and then move up again. Leave the protective cover of the rocks here. It's amazing when you know your ammo is going to penetrate and cause severe damage. You don't rush your shots as much as you do with the M103 or the M60 with the default ammo. The M46 or something with just crap ammo for the default round. Definitely some type of enemy right up here. Oh, shit! Well, I was gonna go for the cheek of his turret there. But I just didn't have time. Here we go, T10 Battle 7. I am gonna spawn here and I'm gonna head... Initially, I was actually going to head for C, but that takes me pretty far away from the battle, and it's a little bit boring, so in the interest of intentionally making this part of a video rather than just making a video out of a match that turns out to be good, I'm going to head for B. Fairly equidistant, I'm much more likely to run into contact at B than I am at C. But we'll call it a wash and go for what should be a more interesting fight, I think. And less time driving. That's the only thing with C, is the terrain takes a little longer to get there. I've got less path to focus on to head to B. Or to head to C, rather. No, B, yeah. And the terrain is more restrictive, but the terrain on C is more hills and long, long, long driving paths. But yeah, so far, being more than halfway through, initial thoughts are, yeah, this tank is pretty much as I thought, much more readily usable, much more combat ready in its default stock state than any other tier 5 I've run into so far, even including the T-54 1947, although, to be fair, it's been so long since I had the T-54 1947 unlocked and researched, and battle ratings were so different and everything back then that I honestly don't really remember my first few battles with that. Except that I probably hated it because, well, after all, it's a T-54. I am looking forward to getting the T-54-51 purely for the extra ammo it gets. It'll probably be... It's going to end up being the last thing I'm going to research in the Russian Tier 5, just because I'm going to have the... Somebody else must be here. Nope, I'm not in the point yet. The map said I was in the point, but reality says I'm not. Okay, what do we got? Is that a Conqueror up there? Nope. Boy, that sure looked like a tank up there. That's crazy. Watch this way. Well, it doesn't reverse terribly well. Alright, we got that cap. Most of the enemy team and most of the enemy team probably went for A. There's actually not very many people out there on our team. They're fairly well spread out. Alright, they're heading for C. I'm going to head over towards spawn here a little bit. They're going to get to C long before I can get to it, so... Unless our guy at C gets killed. I'm going to head here and look for some contact, try to get into a fight. A is probably where they need the most help. Yeah, let's see if we can go spot somebody over here and shoot at him at A. Just do a quick six check. Doesn't look like anything. Don't see anything readily apparent. A little shooting off to the right there. Not sure. Definitely have some guys on A. I don't know if I can see them from all the... Yes, I can see them from all the way up here. Oh, I can see him too. Alright then. Let's see if I can get a hit on that T-32. Just hit right in between them. Worst possible shot I could have made. Well. That's, Oh, there we go, hang on. Jeez. Ricochet off the top of his engine deck cover. And there's somebody looking at me now. He definitely saw that shot coming. Okay, good. He didn't calculate properly either. That's good. Alright, we're gonna get in some battle now. We got 3 to 4 targets all spread out left to right in front of us. At least one serious threat in that M103, and not going to get the gun ready for that Tiger there in time. And M103, not just the most serious threat because of its gun, but also because it knows I'm here. And already shot at me once. Okay. What do we got? What have we got? Alright, that's a tree. There's something right up there. Oh, there he is. I've got the advantage here. Oh. Got the advantage here, too. Mostly because he just bounced one off me somehow. Looks like he's a Tiger H, probably. If I aim this properly enough, I can take him out. Yep. Yeah, like I was saying, much more combat ready in a stock state than any other comparable tier 5 type battle wagon. I mean, the default round alone, comparative to, okay, I guess if you just want to give me that shot, I'll take it. Too bad I didn't see it sooner. Where to go, where to go? I don't really think coming up over the top of the crest of that hill is a great idea. So we'll come around this curve here and come up the backside if we can help it. Alright, let's see. See anybody down there in the village. This is probably not going to work. I think we're a little too steep here. Might be able to make it up this side. Did make it up the climb. And hey, look what we got here. Can we get a shot on him before he gets into cover? Nope. But shoot. Come on, move. Move, you dumb thing. Get a shot in the back of this tiger, though. Certainly enough. Darn it! Just couldn't quite get moving fast enough. But again, 3 ground targets destroyed again for the second time in my first 2 matches with the T10. Just clearly more ready for combat than anything else. Tier 5. Here we go, match 7. It's a nice little domination. That's very good to see. I like, I'm gonna head for A, as I've been doing lately on this map, and any case, in a domination map. It's a pretty easy cap, especially from this side. You can sit on the backside of a hill and be pretty protected. And then, of course, I'm in a T10 now, so. Yeah, I shudder to think how easy it's going to be when this thing is fully spaded. Although, by the time I'm able to get it fully spaded, there's likely to be more higher level enemies for it, and it'll kind of be the case of my IS-3. By the time the IS-3 was just absolutely the king of high tier tank battles, and then by the time I got it, it had been pushed up to 7.7, and the T10 had come along, and the IS-4 had come along, and just, it, you know, it, by the time I got it, it was just too late to enjoy all the complete and utter smashing it was doing. And I despise the thing because it's such a slow pig and has no gun depression in 7.7 right now, or it's a 7.3 or whatever it is right now. 7.0, I forget what they moved it to. I haven't paid attention to the new BRs just yet after the last BR change. But the speed and armor this thing has, not a problem getting to A. Not a problem getting to A at all. Let's see what kind of gun depression I have. Not quite enough for over there. Alright, that's not surprising. Only problem with all the Soviet tanks of this era and level and design is the gun depression. Gun depression is not there. But I suppose when you can drive right up to somebody and... sugar shit, what was that? I'm not sure what just hit me. From where? Right up there on top of the hill? I think right up there on top of the hill. Right about there. No, that's a bunker. Okay, I don't know what just hit me. I don't see a hit on my tank anywhere specifically. Something on the right side? Something hit me on the right side, maybe? I honestly can't tell where that shot came from. Lost the commander. It certainly didn't sound like it was a heat explosion, so I'm not sure what it was. I saw him take a hit. Where did he take the hit from? Now we're taking C. I'm not going to get to it in time. But something's up there fighting. That was a big hit in the back. What is shooting at me? Again, amazing. I've taken two hits to my turret. And I lost the commander, it seems. Okay, there's somebody to shoot at. Come on, get up there, get up there, get up there, get up there. Come on, gun. Come on, gun. Okay. Couldn't tell if that was a player or not. I'll take the RP. This is going to be one long video for as long as I've been lasting in the T10 as compared to the 10 matches in like 10 matches in about 20 minutes I got out of the M103 and the M60. Come on, drive. Drive, damn it. And load. Loading would also be good right now. Loading would also be good right now. That's the first time I've been set on fire by anything. No FPE. Thus endeth match 7. Not entirely sure where I took the hit from. I'm sure it wasn't down there, which means it was another backwards shot view. I don't see anybody. Oh. What? Wow. Alright, that's a little bit BS-y. But okay. Match number 9 in the T10, and the first time we've run into a break battle. Let's see which way to go. We'll head up this way, since break is kind of a get there fast sort of deal, rather than trying to take the long way around the mountains when I've already started out facing. I basically had to make more than a 90 degree turn to get there, so. Go this way, we'll head up through this valley and see if we can't get over to B fast enough. It's gonna be tricky, but I think the engine power in the T10 is obviously up to the task. Strong engine from Tractor Factory. Alright, Americans and Germans. No trouble at all climbing that hill, barely even slowed down. Look at those RPMs go. Watch that in an M60 match sometime. The RPM's coming up a hill like that. And I'm keeping pace with the ZSU-57 here. Of course, he's cutting inside of me and not really... There we go, that's better. Alright. Clear path, unless there's Leos over here, which they're likely to be. Well, going in for the cat. And we'll watch from there. What are you shooting at, dude? Whatever you're shooting at, hit it so I can see it. Okay. Got one over there. Where's the SU shooting at? Whatever it is. Alright, let's, I know I'm facing the wrong way for the castle. Yep! Well, he wasn't coming out of the castle. Wow, with a dart. Alright, here we go. Match number 10 and final for this video. Eastern Europe conquest, not bad. Certainly know how to get here and capture this point. Let's see if we can pull it off in the T10 with this mobilita. Yeah, take that. I will liberate you in brotherhood, tree. Oops. Don't hit the building. All right, baby, come on, accelerate. Need that acceleration. Let's see. Show us what you got. Come on. Uncle Joseph is watching. Of course, by the time this tank comes out, it's probably Uncle Nikita. But, semantics. Or I should say, semantics. Alright, see if we can sneak into that point there and start the capturing. Somebody's putting artillery on it. No big deal. No big deal. Yep, we're gonna be out there all alone. A T3. That'll help us. What are we fighting? Yeah, Americans and Germans again. Alright. Well, pull up right here and watch out for that Leo to come around the corner. Most dangerous thing that could happen. Get some cover out of the team here. There it is. Yeah, the loader has been dazed, but we ain't gonna lose. Shit! How the frickin' hell? Yep, I knew it. God damn it, I knew it. I knew he had heat FS. How the hell did that deflect? Oh, we are boned. If he's got half a brain, he'll come around that corner right there, this way, and kill me. Mouse coming. Defend the A point. Repairing. What? I have a breach? Crap. The hell did I just take a hit from? The hell did I just take a hit from? Where am I taking hits from? Up on the hill. Turn back towards. No, move, 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 you stupid thing! See ya, comrade. That M47 gave up a huge opportunity to kill me there. Shit. Actually, I need to see what my repair, my reload rather, reload rate is now that I lost my loader. Where did I take that hit from? Got like four different ways to worry about here. There's a mouse. Damn! Couldn't find out what the heck the reload was. Is that the one that I hit? Wow. Interesting. Well, anyway, that's the first 10 missions in my T10. Yeah, obviously much better results than my, we'll get a little bonus footage with the PE-8 and see if I can't score another big bomb hit here. Certainly a much better results than either my M103 or M60 first 10 battle videos. I mean, that was pretty much the assumption going into the video, was that was how it was going to be. Definitely much better, much more combat-worthy vehicle in its stock state than anything else that I've driven so far. I haven't gotten to the British yet, so maybe by the time I get to the Conqueror, the Chieftain, is there a Chieftain? I don't know, I haven't gotten that far. By the time I get above tier 2 or 3 in Britain and get to tier 4 and 5, there'll be some... this morning I did see the dev blog about them redoing the Centurion's turret armor, so maybe the Centurion will be a lot more able to handle combat in its default state. I think the default ammo for the British is APDS, or is it HESH? I don't know off the top of my head, but looks like we're going to get a kill here, so this will be entertaining. But anyway, initial thoughts, yes, definitely worth it if you want to completely debase yourself. And told you to stay off A. They were capping it. Anyway, yeah, for conclusions, T10 is just as horrible as something to, just as horribly good to drive it as it is horribly awful to fight against.